Lawrence. Lawrence Okoli, IFLT, the MTK Global. We've just witnessed an absolutely epic fight between Chris Eubank Jr. and George Groves. George Groves retaining WBA Super title, adding the IBL crown. How did you assess the fight?
I assessed it, George was boxing well on the back foot, sort of circling around the ring, and Chris was finding it difficult to cut him off, but it was a fantastic spectacle. And Chris showed that he's got that warrior code that he did talk about, which is not giving up to the last minute, and pushed it to the wire.
Did you expect Chris Eubank Jr. to come out victorious in this fight? Is it a bit of a shock to you, the result and the way the fight panned out?
In a sense, yeah, because I thought that Chris would be able to get to him a little bit more often, and I think that George's shoulder looked like it popped out in the last round. It was a crazy fight. Sure.
George Groves, again, as mentioned, do you think this will be a career-defining performance from him? Do you think this is the best we've seen George Groves?
I think it's the best we've seen him late on, especially. He held his composure, boxed very well, boxed a plan, and it was great. But then on the other side, you've also got Chris. He came into this, yes, he lost the fight, but he won, I think, in the eyes of the public, put a great performance in, and now you want to see what he does next.
Where does Chris Eubank Jr., in your opinion, go from here? What's next for Chris Eubank Jr.? What do you think you can see him doing?
Really, the world's his oyster, because he took some big shots from one of the hardest punches in super middleweights, clean, and kept coming. So I think that he really does have that chin that everyone spoke about. So he can stay at super middle, but I'd like to see him in some wars at middleweight.
Do you think it would be better for him to go back down to 160 and campaign at middleweight? Do you think he would have more natural power, maybe more natural athleticism at 160, Lawrence?
Yeah, maybe. Maybe, yeah. I liked what I saw from him today. Obviously, he didn't win the fight, but I'm excited.
Let's talk a little bit about the source, what's going on, what's the plans at the moment, everything's going all right?
Everything's going all right. Obviously, I had my fight the other week, so I'm still picking training back up. We're trying to debate whether or not I get on the AJ card or not. If not, then I'll be on either the Khan card or Hey Venue, depending on which one opens up. But for me, in terms of what I want to do now, we're still thinking. Obviously, I had to beat Isaac. You know, there was a lot of beef. It was going back and forth for a long, long time. So I wanted to set that step up to beat Isaac. So we want to see. We want to see if we take a little step back down and do a bit more learning before we start pushing for British titles, or do we go for it? It's a team decision, but I'm ready for whatever.
Now, you got the W against Isaac Chamberlain. We know there was a lot of bad beef and whatever the case may be. Having looked back on that fight, do you think some of the criticism and negativity towards the fight and the fighters was undeserved, in your opinion?
When it says undeserved, I think that it's a thought that caught flame and went a bit overboard. In terms of it, it's a 9-0 fighter versus a 7-0 fighter at the time. So that's the kind of fight it was. For me personally, I had beef, we got settled. I had beef, I won. So for me, I'm happy.
Have you had a chance to clear the air with Isaac Chamberlain? Are you and him now sort of back before you were, before all the build-up and the premeditated hype, but is it now sorted?
For me, I won. I went home and I showed the belt to my mum and my little sister. So I'm at peace with myself in terms of the competitive beef that we had. Obviously, Isaac's probably going to still be gunning, hopefully to get a rematch with me at some point in his career. But in terms of his friends don't know, comment on my page. My friends don't comment on his. We haven't had any run-ins yet, so I'm good right now.
Listen, you both put it on the line, you've got in the ring and sorted your differences out, so it's a gentleman's sport. It'd be good to see you both conducting
100%, 100%. And if anything, he's a good fighter with a lot of speed, so we'll probably end up being sparring partners at some point.
That'd be fantastic. Thank you very much to our whole TV champion.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Cheers. Thank you.